discussing the meaning and objective of accounts, link of the previous video is given in the description box below. There we discussed meaning and objective account. Today we will discussing some basic terms like liabilities. Liabilities are the obligation or the debts that an enterprise has to pay at some time in the future. They represent creditors' claim on the firm's asset. Both the small and the big business find it necessary to borrow money at one time or other and to purchase the goods on credit. Next topic is capital. Amount invested by the owner in the firm is known as capital. It may be brought in the form of cash or asset by the owner for the business entity. Capital is an obligation and a claim on the asset of the business. It is therefore shown in the liability side of the balance sheet. Next point is sales. Sales are the total revenue from goods or services sold or provided to the customers. Sales may be cash or credit. Next point is revenue. These are the amount of the business earned by selling its product or providing service to the customers. It also called sales revenue. Other items of revenue common to many businesses are commission, interest, dividend, etc. Next point is expenses. Cost incurred by the business in the process of earning revenue are known as expenses. Generally, expenses are measured by the cost of asset consumed or services used during an accounting period. And some example of expenses are depreciation, rent, wages, salaries, etc. Next point is profit. The excess of the revenue of a period over its related expenses during an accounting year is known as profit. And profit increases the investment of the owner. Next term is gain. A profit that has arises from the events or the transaction which are incidental to the business, such as sales of fixed asset, winning of court case, etc. Next term is loss. The excess of the expenses of a period over its related revenue is termed as a loss. In simple way, you can say if the income is less than the expenses, then this term is called as loss. Next, our term is goods. It refers to the product in which business unit is dealing, that is, in terms which it is buying and selling or producting and selling. These items are the purchased for the use in the business are not called goods. For example, for a furniture dealer, purchase of a chair and table systems as good, while the other it is furniture and is treated as an asset. Next term is drawings. Withdrawal of money and or goods by the owner from the business for personal use is known as a drawing. Purchase. Purchase are the total amount of goods procured by a business on credit or on cash for use or sale. And purchase can be many types, like raw materials purchase or any finished goods purchase, etc. Next, our topic is stock. Stock or inventory is the measure of something on hand, goods, spares and other items in a business. It is called stock in hand. In trading concern, the stock on hand is the amount of goods which are lying unsold at the end of an accounting period. Next topic or next term is debtors. Debtors are the persons or another entities or parties who buy goods on credit. Total amount of standing against such person or entities or a parties on the closing date is shown on the asset side of the balance sheet. Next and the last term is creditors. Creditors are the person or other entities have to be paid by an enterprise an amount for providing the enterprise goods and services on credit. The total amount standing to the favor of such person or entities on the closing date is shown in the balance sheet as a syndicators on the liability side. That's all for today. Thank you, and keep following us for more such updates.